The Cancer Genome Atlas, or TCGA, is a landmark cancer genomics program to molecularly characterize over 11,000 primary cancer and matched normal samples spanning 33 cancer types. The joint effort between NCI and the National Human Genome Research Institute began in 2006, bringing together researchers from diverse disciplines and multiple institutions. Over the past 15 years, TCGA has generated over 2.5 petabytes of genomic, epigenomic, transcriptomic, and proteomic data. The data, which has already led to improvements in our ability to diagnose, treat, and prevent cancer, will remain publicly available for anyone in the research community to use. All data collected and processed by the program is currently available at the NCI Cancer Research Data Commons, or CRDC. The NCI CRDC is a cloud-based data science infrastructure that connects datasets with analytics tools to allow users to share, integrate, analyze, and visualize cancer research data to drive scientific discovery. In addition to the TCGA data, CRDC also provides access to data from other NCI programs such as the Therapeutically Applicable Research to Generate Effective Treatments, also known as TARGET, and the Clinical Proteomics Tumor Analysis Consortium, or CPTAC, through various platforms. These include the Genomic Data Commons, GDC, the Proteomic Data Commons, PDC, Imaging Data Commons, IDC, Cancer Data Service, CDS, Integrated Canine Data Commons, ICDC, and Clinical Trial Data Commons, CTDC. The Genomic Data Commons, GDC, data portal provides users with web-based access to data from cancer genomic studies. The front page displays a summary of all available datasets. The GDC data portal provides 5 navigation options for browsing available harmonized datasets. These include the navigations based on project, exploration, analysis, repository, or human anatomical sites. Each view provides a distinct representation of the same underlying set of GDC data and metadata. The toolbar available at the top of all pages in the GDC data portal also provides convenient navigation links and access to authentication and quick search. The left portion of this toolbar provides access to the home page, projects page, exploration page, analysis page, and a link to repository page. The right portion of this toolbar provides access to quick search, manage sets, authentication functions, the cart, and the GDC apps menu. The projects link directs users to the projects page, which gives an overall summary of project level information, including the available data for each project. It also provides filtering, navigation, and advanced visualization features that allow users to identify and browse projects of interest. On the left, a panel of facets allow users to apply filters to find projects of interest. When facet filters are applied, the table and visualizations on the right are updated to display only the matching projects. When no filters are applied, all projects are displayed. The top right side of the projects page displays a few visualizations of the data, such as the top mutated genes in selected projects and case distribution per project. Hovering the cursor over each bar will display information about the number of cases affected by the disease type, and clicking on each bar will launch the gene summary page for the gene associated with the mutation. Users can toggle the y-axis of this bar graph between a percentage or raw number of cases affected. Below these graphs is a table that contains a list of projects and details about each project, such as the number of cases and data files. The table provides links to project summary pages in the project ID column. Columns with file and case counts include links to open the corresponding files or cases in repository page. The graph tab contains an interactive view of information in the table tab. The numerical values in case count, file count, and file size columns are represented by bars of varying length according to size. These columns are sorted independently in descending order. Mousing over an element of the graph connects it to associated elements in other columns, including project ID and major primary sites. Most elements in the graph are clickable, allowing the user to open the associated cases or files in repository page. Like the projects table, the graph will reflect any applied facet filters. The exploration page allows users to explore data in the GDC using advanced filters, which includes those on a gene and mutation level. Users choose filters on specific cases, genes or mutations on the left of this page, and then can visualize these results on the right. There is also a clinical tab with filters that apply specifically to clinical data. As users add filters to the data on the exploration page, the results section will automatically be updated. Results are divided into different tabs: cases, genes, mutations, and oncogrid. The cases tab gives an overview of all the cases who correspond to the filters chosen. The top of this section contains a few pie graphs with categorical information regarding the primary site, project, disease type, gender, and vital status. Below these pie charts is a tabular view of cases, which can be exported, sorted, and saved using the buttons on the right. The case summary page displays case details including the project and disease information, data files that are available for that case, and the experimental strategies employed. The genes tab will give an overview of all the genes that match the criteria of the filters. The top of this tab contains a bar graph of the most frequently mutated genes. Hovering over each bar in the plot will display information about the percentage of cases affected. In addition, this section contains a survival curve. The survival curve is calculated using the Kaplan-Meier estimator based on all cases with survival data within the specified exploration page search. Users may choose to download the underlying data in JSON or TSV format, or an image of the graph in SVG or PNG format by clicking the download icon at the top of each graph. Gene summary pages describe each gene with mutation data and provides results related to the analyses that are performed on these genes. A table shows how many cases are affected by mutations and copy number variation within the gene as a ratio and percentage. Under the protein view, mutations and their frequency across cases are mapped to a graphical visualization of protein coding regions with a lollipop plot. FAM domains are highlighted along the x-axis to assign functionality to specific protein coding regions. The bottom track represents a view of the full gene length. Different transcripts can be selected by using the drop-down menu above the plot. The panel to the right of the plot allows the plot to be filtered by mutation consequences or impact. The plot will dynamically change as filters are applied. Mutation consequence and impact is denoted in the plot by color. The Mutations tab contains information about one somatic mutation and how it affects the associated gene. Each mutation is identified by its chromosomal position and nucleotide level change. A table shows how many cases are affected by the particular mutation. You can compare the effects of different mutations on the survival curve. The exploration page also includes an oncogrid plot of the cases with the most mutations for the top 50 mutated genes affected by high-impact mutations. Genes displayed on the left of the y-axis correspond to individual cases on the x-axis. Additionally, the plot also indicates in each cell any CNV events detected for these top mutated cases and genes. The grid is color-coded with a legend at the top which describes what type of mutation consequence and CNV event is observed for each gene and case combination. Clinical information and the available data for each case are available at the bottom of the grid. In addition to the exploration page, the GDC Data Portal also has features used to save and compare sets of cases, genes, and mutations. These sets can either be generated with existing filters or through custom selection. There are three tabs on this page. The users can select either to do set operations, cohort comparison, or clinical data analysis. The Results tab is where users can view the results of current or previous set analyses. Finally, the repository page is the primary method of accessing data in the GDC data portal. The individual file can either be downloaded individually from file summary pages or collected in the file cart to be downloaded as a bundle. Clicking on the shopping cart icon that is next to any item in the GDC will add the item to your cart.